Several weeks ago, we talked about a fake HP 65W power adapter, and today we got another genuine 65W power adapter from HP. It has dual USB-C output ports and adopts GaN components. We're gonna take it apart to see if it's better than the fake one. This charger is sold separately, so there is an exquisite box printed with the product name. The major selling points are on the side of the packaging. Open the box. And take out all items inside. Except for the charger itself, it also contains an AC power cord, dual USB-C cable, and some documents. Here is the AC power cord. This side connects to the charger, and the AC plug is connected to your outlet. The length is about 1 meter. It also comes with a dual USB-C cable. The length is the same as the power cord, about 1 meter. The ChargerLab Power ZKM002C shows it integrates an e-market chip and can support 20V, 5A, 100W. It can also support USB 3.2 Gen1 and 5 gigabits per second. The charger adopts matte surface and the HP is engraved in the center. An LED indicator light is at the top. The 3-prong socket can support grounding and avoid electric shock. There are two USB-C output ports on the other side. Flip to the back, let's take a look at the specs info. Model is TPN-DA27. It can support input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60s, 1.7 amp, and the output power of a single board can be up to 65 watts. When charging two devices, the power can be divided into 45 watts, 20 watts, or 30 watts, 30 watts. The manufacturer is Delta Electronics. It also has passed tons of certifications and standards to ensure its safety. The size of this charger is about 75x53x23mm. The weight of the adapter is about 116 grams. With two cables, the total weight is about 235 grams. After connecting to the power supply, the indicator will light up. The ChargerLab Power ZKM002C shows one of the USB-C ports supports AFC, QC 3.0, QC5, PD 3.0, and PPS protocols. And it also supports 5 fixed speeds of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 5A, 15V, 4.33A, 20V, 3.25A, and a set of PPS. And the supported protocols and PDO info of the other USB-C port are the same, which means you can use any USB-C port to get the same charging experience. After the brief introduction, let's take it apart to see what components are inside. Use the spudger to pry along the gap and remove the top and bottom covers. Pull out the entire module from the bottom. It's covered with a copper heat sink for heat dissipation. Here are the input, output wires, and a grounding wire. Then let's remove the heatsink. A layer of yellow tape is pasted under the heatsink for insulation. Those heating components on the front and back are covered with silicone adhesives. As we can see, there is a small PCB on the top and right side. Take a closer look from the side. ChargerLab found it adopts QF flyback topology and outputs a fixed voltage. The current will be filtered by synchronous rectification circuit for output. Then let's introduce every single component. The input time delay fuse is from WalterFuse, 3.15 amp, 250 volts. The first common mode choke is wound with magnet wires and insulated wires. And the second common mode choke is wound with magnet wires. Some silicon adhesives are placed between them. The safety X2 capacitor is 0.33 microfarad. This 3A bridge rectifier for input filtering is on the back. This electrolytic capacitor for input filtering is from Chinsan, 100 microfarad, 420 volts. The mass control chip is from Weltrend and adopts SOP8 package. It's a multi-mode flyback controller and supports high voltage startup. It also integrates X capacitor discharge. The GaN FET is from Transphorm and adopts a DFN 8x8 package, 650 volts, 240 milliohm. This tiny capacitor that powers the mass control chip is from Rubycon, 100 volts, 10 microfarad. The largest component is the transformer from Delta, and the magnetic core is wrapped with copper foil. This is an EL1013 optocoupler used to regulate the output voltage. The synchronous rectification controller is from MPS, which can support fast turnoff. The synchronous rectifier is actually the MOSFET from Infineon, 100 volts, 4 milliohm. This solid output capacitor is 25 volts, 470 microfarad. The protocol chip is soldered on a separate small output PCB from Infineon CCG7DC series. It also integrates two buck boost controllers designed for multi-port chargers. This is a 3.3 microhenry alloy inductor for buck output. Those two synchronous buck MOSFETs are from Advanced Power, which adopts PMPAK 3x3 package, 30 volts, 4.2 milliohm. Those two SMD solar capacitors for output filtering are from KEMET, 100 microfarad, 25 volts. Here is the output circuit for another USB-C port. The alloy inductor, buck MOSFETs, and SMD solar capacitors are the same as the other circuit. This is the indicator light. Here are two USB-C connectors engraved with LOTES. Two VBUS MOSFET of two buck circuits are also from Advanced Power, 30 volts, 4.2 milliohm. Oh, that's all components of this 65W dual USB-C GaN charger from HP. The most impressive is that the AC power cord and USB-C cable can be detached, so you can use other cables to replace them. After taking apart, we found it adopts GaN FET and SMD capacitors to make the charger's size even smaller. And the internal components are all from some well-known brands like Transphorm, Rubycon, KEMET, and Delta. Compared with fake HP charger, the quality is much better. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!